Hi guys, welcome back to today's video. Motorola's recently released MOTO X30 Pro comes with a 125W GaN fast charger. With this charger, the phone can be charged 50% in 7 minutes and fully charged in 90 minutes. And it also supports 100W PD fast charging, which is convenient for charging your laptop and other devices. Let's take it apart and see what it looks like inside. This black matte shell can reduce fingerprints, and the Motorola brand logo is in the middle. There's only one USB-C port, and the internal plate is red. Pretty striking. The 125W is printed on the other side, and the input prongs cannot be folded. All specs info are printed at the bottom, model is MC-1258. It can support input of 120 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 1.7 amp, and the output can be up to 125 watts. The manufacturer is Ohi Technology. The size of this charger is about 55 by 56 by 29 mm. Compared with Apple 140 watts charger, the size is much smaller. And the weight is 152 grams. The ChargerLab Power ZKM002C shows the USB-C supports QC3.0, PD3.0, PBS, QC5, and Apple 2.4M protocol. It also supports 5 fixed PDLs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 5A, and 2 sets of PBS. Except for this, it also supports 20V, 6.25A, which is the Motorola's private protocol. Next, let's go ahead and take it apart to see its internal components. Use the cutting machine to separate the shell. The entire PCBA module is covered with silicone adhesives. The graphite thermal sheet can enhance heat dissipation. Clean up the PCBA module. The planar transformer is placed in the hollow of the PCB to reduce the thickness. The PFC inductor is in the center, and the output end is at the bottom. Flip to the back, we can see all SMD components. ChargerLab found it consists of PFC boost circuits and QR flyback topology. The output voltage is regulated by the optocoupler and controlled by the protocol chip. Let's introduce every single component. The input fuse is insulated with heat shrinkable tube. The green NTC thermistor is used to suppress inrush current and reduce sparkling when plugged into the outlet. The blue varistor is from STE and is used for input or voltage protection. The first common mode choke is wound with different wires and insulated with heat shrinkable tube. The safety X2 capacitor is from STE, 0.33 microfarad. The second common mode choke is wound with flat copper wire. The thermal fuse is from Better Electronics. Its melting temperature is 150 degrees Celsius. It is fixed on the common mode choke to detect the temperature for overheating protection. Two bridge rectifiers are soldered on the front and back of the PCB, which can dissipate heat evenly and convert AC into pulsed DC. The red film capacitor for output filtering is from STE, 0.68 microfarad, 450 volts. The toroidal coil inductor is also used for output filtering. Another film capacitor is from CARLI, 1 microfarad, 450 volts. The PFC boost controller is from Silergy, which is a PFC controller operating in critical mode. It drives the boost converter in the QL mode for high efficiency and better EMI performance. The PFC boost transistor is from Navitas NV6134A, which is the latest GaN power IC of the GaN Fast series. It integrates GaN Sense Learnless Current Sampling technology and no external resistor is required, which improves charger efficiency, reduces heat, and can save more space. It also has overtemperature, overcurrent, and other protections, ensuring the charger's reliability. The PFC boost inductor is insulated with a plastic case. Here is the fast recovery diode for PFC rectification. Those three input capacitors are all from SAMXON, 400 volts, 15 microfarad. The other one is 400 volts, 22 microfarad. Here is the power supply capacitor for powering the PFC and primary controller, 100 volts, 10 microfarad. The primary controller is from ON Semiconductor. It integrates high voltage startup and active X2 capacitor discharge features. The primary GaN power IC is also from Navitas NV6134A, same as the PFC circuit. So there are two Navitas GaN power ICs inside this charger. The synchronous rectifier controller is from Drawbot, which can prevent the gate from being coupled to the turn-on voltage during startup. The synchronous rectifier is from Rokiga and adopts PDFN5x6 package, 100 volts, 3.8 milliohm. Two solid capacitors for output filtering are from Barrel Electronics. They are connected in parallel, 470 microfarad, 25 volts. A QR code and other info are printed on the side of the magnetic core. Two sets of SMDY capacitors are on the front and back sides of the PCB. They are connected in series to improve the safety level. The blue Y capacitor is from ISND. Two EL1019 optocouplers are used to regulate the upper voltage and control the PFC circuit. Another solid capacitor is also from Barrel Electronics, 25 volts, 470 microfarad. The protocol chip is from Ingenic, which integrates multiple protocols. It only needs very few external components, which effectively reduce the size and cost. The output VBUS MOSFET is from Vanguard and adopts PDFN3333 package, 30 volts, 3 milliohm. Here is the USB-C receptacle with a red plate inside. Well, that's all components of this original 125W GaN charger for MOTO X30 Pro. It's designed with fixed prongs and black matte shell, and it can support up to 125W when charging MOTO X30 Pro and is compatible with 100W PD fast charging. The internal module is very compact, and the planar transformer can greatly reduce the thickness. We found this charger consists of PFC circuit and QR topology. There are two Navitas GaN power ICs inside, model is NV6134. One of them is used for the PFC boost circuit, and the other one is used for the QR topology of the switching power supply. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you like this video, please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye.